गुड मॉर्निंग
गुड मॉर्निंग सर। गुड
ऑल। ओके सर।
मॉर्निंग सर।
यस। So we were studying the topic testing of molding sand. Before this, we have seen the different types of properties of molding sand which we require to in order to get the good quality of casting. Now, in order to check those properties, whether molding sand possesses those properties or not, we need to go for the number of tests. Out of this, these are the four tests which are there for our syllabus. Moisture content test, clay content test, grain size test, and permeability test. How to conduct this test? What are the purpose of this test? That we are going to see one by one. In the last class, we have seen the permeability test. So once again, I will explain that permeability test, and then we will go for the other test. So what is permeability test? In the last lecture, we have seen we prepare a sample and we allow the air to pass through that sample, and we will note down the time required for that air to pass that sample. Okay. So here you can see the two machines. So this is the first one, second one. So in the first, you can see here. The cylinder. So this cylinder is used to prepare the specimen. So we need to test the permeability of a sand, which where we are using the sand. Suppose that is a molding sand we are using. So we need to test whether it is a permeable or not. So in order to check that, we take some amount of molding sand. So nearly 50 grams. We take a sample from our molding sand, and from that sample sand that is of 50 grams, we prepare the specimen. So for keeping standard, we have the standard dimensions of our specimen. That is, its a diameter is 50.8 mm or 5.08 centimeter, and length is also same, 50.8 mm. So we need to first prepare the sample. So how we'll prepare the sample? So this cylinder here, you can see the cylinder. Okay. So in that cylinder, we will pour our molding sand. And that cylinder we will keep here. You can see here. And so we will have this ramming. So we will, with the help of this ram, we will ram that sand, and we will prepare the molding of size 50 height, that is 50.8 mm, with the help of this ram. So the, here you can see the wheel, okay, and here you can see the press. So with the help, while rotating that, we will apply the pressure, and we will reduce that to 50.8. And with the help of this ramming process, we will get our specimen of 50.8 mm and 50.8 mm length and 50.8 mm diameter. So this is the instrument which is used to prepare the specimen, right? Once we have prepared the specimen, we will keep that specimen in this instrument to check the permeability. That sample we will keep in this. So what we do in this, we will allow the air to pass through a standard specimen. So this is specimen. So air will be passed through this. Here we are taking the standard air, that is 2000 cc cubic centimeter cube volume. This is the volume of air. which we are passing. So these are the steps. So first step is the air which is having 2000 centimeter cube volume is passed through this sand specimen. Whatever the specimen we have prepared, we will allow that air to pass through this much volume, right? Now what, so slowly this air will pass through this molding sand and it will come out of this other end, right? Now at that time we need to maintain the pressure. So pressure is also standard 10 gram per centimeter square. Here you can see, here it is the pressure reading. Here you can check the pressure. We need to maintain that, we need to see that pressure, whether it is 10 gram per centimeter or not. So these are the standard conditions: specimen size, then pressure and the value. Now what will change here? The time. We need to find the time. Which time? So time required for this much amount of volume of air to pass the specimen, that we need to record. And once we record that time, we will find out the permeability of that molding sand, whether it is have good permeability or not. So how to find that? We will see that with one example. So this detail about this permeability yesterday we have seen. Now here you can see the problem. Determine the permeability of a AFS standard. AFS means American Foundry Society standard sand specimen of 5.08 centimeter diameter and 5.08 centimeter high. This is standard. The air, what is the value of air? 2000 cc cubic centimeter was allowed to escape through the sand specimen at a pressure 10 gram per here it is centimeter square in a span of 15 seconds. Time recorded here it is what? T is equal to 15 seconds, right? We need to find the permeability. So how we will find the permeability? So what is the permeability number? Permeability number is equal to, what is the formula? V into H upon, V is the volume of air, H is the height of specimen. Then what we have the pressure, which is 10 gram per centimeter square. Then we have the area, cross sectional area of our specimen, and time, which is recorded here, 15 seconds. Volume is 2000, height is 5.08, take in centimeter, okay. Pressure is 10, area, cross section area, yesterday we have calculated. How will you find the cross section area? Pi by 4 into d square, that is 5.08 square into time here, take in second, time we need to take in second. So this permeability number, what is the value we get here? It is around, so if you calculate here, it will come around 200.5, around this. Now, with the help of this value, we will conclude that whether our sand is having good permeability or not. So sample value you can see here. So permeability number depends on the clay content and moisture content. So how to calculate the percentage clay content and percentage moisture content, that we are going to see in the next. So here you can see, if suppose this much amount of clay and moisture content is there, then this is the good permeability. If suppose this permeability number is 310, then you will say that our sand is having good permeability. If moisture content is 2 and 3, moisture content is 3%, percentage of clay is 2, then we will say that 280 is the good permeability. This is how we decide the whether our sand, molding sand, is having good permeability or not. Okay, problems are not there for your syllabus. Just to explain you how we calculate the permeability number, we use this formula and then we calculate. Okay, so all these parameters are constant. All these parameters are constant. Only what we need to check we need to check the time required to pass that air from that particular specimen. So depending on the time, we will decide the permeability number, right? The next is moisture content test. Next test is moisture content test. So how to get the moisture content in that particular sand? So why we need moisture? So how grain strength? Grain strength. So at the start, we are using the fresh sand, right? In order to get a good grain strength. Grain strength means what? Grain means what? Not green in color. Means what? It contains water. So if you see at the start, what is a grain sand? Which contains 20 to 30% of clay and 6 to 7% around this water of total value, right? So then we call it as a grain strength. Now to check the water content, whether there is a less water content or whether there is a more water content, or whether there is a sufficient water content, to check that moisture content, we need to go for this test, right? So this test is called moisture content test. So how we, so again the same, whatever this molding sand we have prepared, so from that molding sand we take the sample. So generally we go for 50 grams of sample, right? And we take that 50 grams sand and then we go for heating. We can heat that by placing it in oven, or we heat by the infrared heater. Okay, so what happens when we heat? Whatever the moisture content is there, that will get evaporated, right? And once we heat for suppose 2 to 3 minutes, then again we take back that molding sand, and what we do, we wet, and the difference in wet will give you a water content. So how this happens, let's see. So here you can see these are the some instruments which are used for conducting the moisture content test. So what we do, first we prepare the molding sand. From that molding sand we take the sample of suppose 50 gram sample molding sand we have taken. So what to do, first take the weight of that sand. Let's suppose that weight is W1, right? What is the weight W1? So when we take the 50 gram, okay, so 50 gram by weighing, we need to take that molding sand, that is 50 gram, right? Then heat it either in the oven or in the infrared heating bulb. Okay, here you can see in the pan, here in the pan we have the molding sand of 50 gram, that is weight W1, and with the help of this infrared heating bulb we are heating for 2 to 3 minutes. Okay, so once we heat that, due to the heating, what will happen? Whatever the moisture content is there, that will get evaporated. And after that, we will take out that molding sand. Okay, and then we will go for measuring. Suppose now the weight is W2. So W2 will be less, because whatever the moisture content is there, that will get evaporated. Now, how to find the percentage of moisture, percentage of moisture, how will find? So the formula is W1, that is initial weight, minus W2, that is final weight after heating, divided by W1, okay, into 100. So by this you will get the moisture content in particular that sand. Let's suppose our W1 is what, 50, right? And we have heated that, and after heating we got the weight 49 divided by 50 initial weight into 100. So it will be nearly about 2% water content is there in our molding sand. With the help of that sample, we can decide whatever the moisture content is there in the molding sand. So if you see this process, how much time it required? First we need to take the 50 gram of sand by weighing it. Then we need to keep in the molding oven. We need to wait for heating. After heating, we need to again go for weighing, and after weighing, we will find the moisture content. Right? So this required time. So this is the traditional method actually, which is moisture content is. So here you can see the instrument. So nowadays, actually, this is not for our syllabus, just for your understanding purpose, just for your knowledge, I am explaining this. So this is the rapid moisture content test instrument. Okay. So again, the method is same. What we are going doing here, we take the initial sand of 50 gram, right? So in this, we are adding calcium carbide. In the sand, what we are adding? We are adding calcium carbide. So what happens when we add a sand which contains moisture with the calcium carbide? So that whatever the moisture content is there, that will react with the calcium chloride, calcium carbide, and that will produce the acetylene gas. Okay, so see here you can see the instrument. So in this, what we do, we add a 50 gram of moisture molding sand plus some amount of calcium carbide, and then we will mix that. So after mixing, whatever the moisture content is there in the molding sand, that will react with the calcium carbide, and that will produce acetylene gas. Okay, now this acetylene gas will exert a pressure, will produce a pressure, and that pressure you can see on this pressure reading. So depending on the pressure reading, we will decide how much the amount of water content is there. If suppose moisture content is more, then it will react with the calcium carbide and it will produce more acetylene gas. When it produces more acetylene gas, it will show the more pressure in this pressure reading, and within 2 to 3 minutes we will get the moisture content. That's why this test is called rapid moisture content test. So understood what we are doing in this? We are taking the molding sand, calcium carbide, we mix it. After mixing, it will produce the acetylene gas. Why it will produce acetylene gas? Because calcium carbide will, when it will come into contact with the moisture, that is water, so it will produce acetylene gas, and that acetylene gas will produce the pressure, and that pressure we will see. Depending on the pressure, whether it is less or more, we will decide the water content. So nowadays, industries are using this also and this also. If suppose they want to reduce the time, then they will go for rapid moisture content, or so they can use the traditional, that is moisture content test. Okay, so this is our,
sir, yes. How to find moisture percentage in second method?
Yes, depending on the pressure. So they will have the correlation between the pressure, whatever the pressure they will get, and they will correlate with the moisture content. Let's suppose there is a 10 gram per centimeter square is the pressure, then that will be equivalent to 2% of water content. If suppose there is a 50 gram per centimeter square, then that will be equivalent to suppose 10 or 12% of water. So they will have the relation between the pressure and the water content. They will have the standard value. Suppose this much amount of pressure is there, then that this means that this much amount of water content is there. So there will be a chart. So depending on the pressure, we will find the, we need not to find, but that will be there in this chart. 50 gram pressure, then suppose 12% is water. Suppose 30 gram per centimeter square pressure is there, then we will say that it is a 8% of water in the moisture. So this is how we decide in the second case, depending on the pressure. Right?
Sir, if
Yes.
we are using backing sand, then
Yes.
also we have to calculate moisture content is.
So for that, no. Backing sand means for that purpose we need to go for the clay content test. So this test for the backing sand we are using this clay content test. For the backing sand, we don't go for moisture content test. We take the moisture content sand, moisture content test for the green sand. Here I have written green for checking the green strength, that is green sand. Okay, and for the backing sand, we go for this clay content test, which I am going to explain. Okay, for the backing sand, we don't perform the moisture content test. Okay,
Yes, sir.
so here there is a clay content test. Clay content test. So, first of all, let's understand why we need to go for this clay content test. So you know we are using backing sand after the facing sand. So to avoid the more number of using fresh sand, so what we are using, we are using used sand, that is backing sand. Now for how much time we can use that molding sand, that is backing sand. So we need to decide that. So there is a one method, either by experience, by color. We can say that whether it is usable or not, or we can perform the clay content test of that sand. So what happens, due to continuously in contact with the molten metal, that is the high temperature, so whatever the clay content is there in the sand, that will go on due to continuously rotation, because the clay is continuously get heated, and due to that the clay percentage decreases. So how much clay percentage is there in the that sand, holding sand, we need to find that. So to perform that clay content test, to find the clay content test, we go for this test. So here you can see, so all these instruments are same. So this is the complete setup. Here you can see, so here you can see the glass, right? In this glass, here you can see the distilled water. Whatever the water you can see, that is distilled water. And in that sand, in that distilled water, we pour the molding sand. Whatever the molding sand we are using, whatever the clay content test you want to check, that molding sand we will pour into this distilled water. And we will start this machine, and we will start to stir. Now, what happened? When we will start to stir? What? So, if you take the composition of molding sand, what it contains? It contains some amount of water. It contains some amount of clay, and remaining amount is what? Silica sand. Now, when we stir that molding sand, so whatever the silica particle is there, that will settle down. Down to this glass tube, and whatever the clay content is there, so that will mix with the water, so that will not settle, that will remain in the upper part, that will not get settled, right? So we will stir up to 2 to 3 minutes. Now, while stirring, so after stirring 2 to 3 minutes, whatever the distilled water is there, that we will remove. So when we remove, so whatever the clay content is there, that will also get removed, and what we'll get? Only at the bottom we will get the silica sand. Silica sand. Understood how we are performing this test? See the procedure for performing the clay content test. So we need to take the sample amount of molding sand. Let's suppose 50 grams of dry sand. Here you can see 50 amount of 50 grams of dry sand means whatever the used sand. And transfer to wash bottle. Wash bottle. This is the wash bottle. Okay, whatever the glass bottle you can see, that is a wash bottle. So now see, whatever the mixture is there, 475 centimeter cube of distilled water, then 50 centimeter cube of NaOH, right, and 50 grams of dry sand. So we mix all this. So this mixture, we mix this for 10 minutes with the help of sand stirrer. You can see here stirrer. This is a stirrer. So with the help of this, here you can see the stirrer. With the help of this, we mix this mixture. And once we mix for 10 minutes, so what happens? Whatever the sand is there, dry sand means silica sand, that will settle at the bottom. And clay, whatever the clay is there, that will remain in this upper part. And we will siphon out. Siphon out means what? We will remove that mixture of water, distilled water, okay, and clay. So once, and how to find the clay content? Same here. See here. Initially, the weight was 50 gram. Then what we had done? We have mixed this distilled water plus NaOH. We have stirred it. Then we have removed the water. And with the help of this water, the water, the clay content is there, that will also get removed. Then at the bottom of this, we will get the silica sand. So remove this silica sand and allow some time for drying of this silica sand. So once it is dried, measure the weight. So this weight of silica sand is 2 meters. Now, how to find the clay content? So percentage of clay content is equal to initial weight of that boulding sand, that is W1, minus final weight, that is the weight of only silica sand, that is W2, divided by W1 into 100. So formula is same, only here we are removing the water clay content with the help of this stirrer. And in the first case, we are removing the moisture content with the help of heating per infrared bulb. We are removing the moisture content. So once we remove the clay content, we will get the weight 2 W2. And with the help of this, we can calculate the clay content test. Now, depending on the percentage of clay content, we will use that sand, right? If suppose percentage of clay content is not sufficient amount, then we will stop using that sand. That is the problem. So this is the clay content test, and this is the instrument which is used for clay content test, then moisture content test and permeability test. Now moving towards the last test, that is the grain.
Sir, yes. Why we need to check clay content test?
Clay content test, what happens? If you see the types of sand, there we use the parting sand, facing sand, backing sand. There are a number of types of sand which we use to prepare the mold. So we use the fresh sand. So fresh sand contains moisture. So we go for that moisture content test. Now we use the backing sand after the facing sand. What is backing sand? That is used sand. Previously we have used that sand for the preparing of molding. Again, we are using the same sand as a backing sand. Now, what happens to this backing sand due to the repetitive use? Repetitive use means what? Every time it is coming in contact with the molten metal. Molten metal means what? It is coming in contact with the high temperature. So due to high temperature, what happens? Whatever the clay content is there, that will get burned. So that percentage of clay content will be reduced, right? Now, as we are using repeatedly that used sand, that is backing sand. So after some time, we need to decide whether we need to use this sand or not, or we need to throw that sand, right? So how we'll decide that? We will decide that on percentage of clay content in that dry sand. So we'll take, when we are using that backing sand, we'll take some sample, we go for performing clay content test, and depending on clay content test, we will decide whether to use that sand or not. So that is the purpose of clay content test, to check that whether there is a proper amount of clay there or not. So what happens if suppose there is a not sufficient amount of clay in the molding sand? So while ramming, if suppose clay content is not there, only silica sand is there. So what happens when we go for ramming? So whatever your molding sand, that will not get closely packed. So you will not get a good strength of molding sand. If you see our sand, we cannot have the packed sand. Okay, that is a loose sand. Why there is a loose? If you take in hand, so that will get loose. Why it is? Because that not contain any amount of clay in that. Okay, so we cannot use that sand. If suppose there is a sufficient amount of clay, then only we can use that sand, because we'll get the good strength of molding sand, right? So that is the purpose of clay content test. Understood?
Sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Sir, the facing sand which we use newly, we are not using the facing sand as the backing sand. So
yes,
for that, we have to perform the moisture and permeability test, not the clay content test, right?
For that also, you can perform the clay content test. For that also, you can go.
Sir, but we are used.
Yes. See, there are two purposes. First is that is dry, whether to use the repetitive sand or not. And second is the in fresh sand also you can go for performing the clay content test. So what happens? See, what happens if suppose there is a large amount of clay is there? If suppose there is a more amount of clay is there in your molding sand, then that may reduce the permeability. Okay, we can go for the means at once we can go for the performing of clay content test for the fresh sand also. So this permeability test and whatever the moisture content test, that is compulsory. In permeability test, you will come to know whether it is having good permeability or not. There you can perform this, but at the start you can perform the clay content test also. So it is not mandatory, but you can perform. There is no any rule that is, but we need to perform this moisture content plus permeability test, right? So you can perform.
Sir, with every sand which we are going to use, dry sand or green sand, parting sand, system sand.
No,
so
parting
all sand, the sands we are going to.
No, for the parting sand, we are not performing in this. Parting sand is just kind of what powder. It is just used for separating the dry cope and rack. There we are not using all type of tests for the parting sand. But for other tests like system sand, green sand, dry sand, we go for testing of this different type of testing. We go for this testing. Yes. And this is also one test, that is grain size test. We will discuss that. Yes. Any other doubt? Shall we go for this grain size test? Sorry, grain size test. So why we go for this grain size test? To find the grain fineness number. Grain fineness number or grain size test is used to perform whether your sand is fine or coarse. Means where there are small particles in your sand or there are large particles in your sand. Sand. To perform that test, we go for this grain size test, or this is also called as a grain fineness number testing method. So what here we have the sieve shaker. So this machine is known as sieve shaker. So here you can see the different stages, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So there are different stages are there. So in this, here you can see the actual diagram of sieve shaker. So you can see the partitions here, right? So this contains different sieves. Here you can see the inside of sieves. So you can see the machines here. So every sieve have different machine. So depending on the machine, we give number to that particular sieve. So that number we are going to see in this. So first we will see how this test is conducted, right? Now, so very fine mesh sieve we will keep at the bottom, and large mesh sieve we will keep at the upper. Okay, so such way we will arrange this sieves by in order how means decreasing the meshing size. Here you can see the meshing size in the first one, meshing size is very large, and in the last one you can see the meshing size is very small, right? Now again we take the some amount of molding sand whose grain size we want to find, right? Suppose let's suppose that is a 50 gram of sand is. So that 50 gram of sand we will keep here. Here means what? At the top. So here you can see. So what are the molding sand of 50 gram is there? We will keep at the top sieve, in the top sieve. Then we will start this sieve shaker. So this will shake this sand. Once it will shake the sand, what will happen? Whatever the sand particles or molding sand particles are there, so that will start to fall. That will start to fall. Now, how it will fall depending on the grain size. Whatever the very small sand particle or the molding sand particles are there, that will be collected here at the bottommost sieve. Then larger than that it will be collected here. So larger grain size it will be collected here. Again larger will be collected here. So depending on the grain size of that sand, so that will be get collected in particular that sieve. Depending on the size, it will get collected into the particular sieve. And we will go for weighing of every sieve, and we will find the grain fineness number. How to find that grain fineness number? That we will see. First of all, see how this grain size test is conducted. Plus the sample dry sand. See here, we are using the dry sand. Dry sand means what? Clay removed sand. In the upper sieve. Upper sieve means here. Whatever the sand we have taken of 50 gram, keep that on into the topmost, which is having highest mesh size. Once we put that sand, vibrate the sieve shaker, means the machine will start and it will start to vibrate. So we will allow some time to vibrate it or to shake it. So what happens when it will shake? What are the small particles of sands are there that will fall down to the respective sieves. Now, once it will fall down, so these are the sieves. Suppose 1, 2, 3, 4. Some amount of sand will be here, some amount of sand will here, some amount of here. So whatever the sand particles are there in every sieve, we will measure that sand particles weight, and by that we will calculate the grain fineness number. Now this is the method how to find, that we'll see in this. Okay, grain fineness number, how to get the grain fineness number. First we have discussed the procedure. After doing that procedure, we get some amount of sand in every sieve, every particular sieve. Let's suppose there are 10 sieves are there. Okay, here you can see pan or clay means the bottommost, where there is a pan, and that way we get very smallest grain size of that molding sand we will get in the pan. Okay. So these are the 10 sieves are there, from starting from the top to bottom. Then depending on the mesh size, we have given the number 16, 30, 40, 52, 60, 70, 100, 150, 200. Such type of sieve number we have given to particular sieve. 16 means suppose there are 16 meshes are there, 30 means there are 13 meshes. As the number of meshes increases, its size reduces. Means what I will explain here. Here you can see mesh size is large. Why? Because number of meshes are less. If you take the second example, you can see number of meshes are more in the second case and the mesh size is small. So depending on that, we will provide the sieve number, right? Now, as I said here, in every particular sieve, we will get some amount of dry sand, right? So that strand, we need to calculate the percentage sand. How will calculate the percentage sand? So total is W1. Let's suppose in that particular we got the W2 upon W1 into 100. So this is how we will get the sand retained. Okay, see here how. So topmost sieve is suppose sieve number 1. So this sieve. In that sand, in that sieve, we got some sand. So measure that sand. So that is suppose, let's suppose it is 5 gram. Whatever the sand is there in the sieve 1, that is suppose 5 gram. So what is the total weight of sand? 50 minus whatever the W2 means. What W2 is? What the sand in the first sieve, that is 5, and total weight is 50. Means what? 50 minus 5 upon 50 into 100. So by this we will calculate the percentage of sand in particular sieve. Whatever the percentage, it will come. So same thing, whatever the percentage of sand is there in the second sieve, that will be in this. Then third one, fourth one, fifth one, sixth one, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is how we will calculate that. So total we have the 50 gram, means it is 100%. So out of that 100%, it will be distributed in 1 to 10. Either it will be into 1, either it will be into 2, and so on. So some amount of sand will be particular that sieve. So depending on that, we will calculate the percentage of sand in particular sieve, right? Then we will have this standard multiplier. 10, 20, 30, 40, 52. These are the standards. They design these numbers. 10, 20, 30, 40, 70, like this. To the particular sieve, they will get the multiplier. Now, in the last column, there is a product. What is the product? Sand retained into that particular multiplier. It is 50. Sorry, 0.50. Then percentage, 22. Percentage sand is there in the second sieve. So multiplier here it is 20. So you will get the 451. Again, 60% sand is there in the third sieve, and the multiplier for the that particular sieve is 30. You will get this product, right? So we will calculate this all and we will get the different products here, right? Now, how to calculate the grain fineness number? So the formula for grain fineness number is, so sum of products divided by sum of percentage weights. Means what? This weight. So that will be, by default it will be 100%, because 50 gram we are pouring at the top. So every particle, every grain will collect in any of these 1 to 10 size. So whatever the percentage we get, that will be 100%, because we are going to retain all the 100% size, right? So whatever the sum products we got, how much we got here in this case? We got 3241.45. We have added all this, right? Divided by percentage weight, every time it will be 100. Okay, So here, how much we will get? 3 to 4 divided by, so it will be 32.41. 32.41 is the grain finest number for particular that sand. Now, depending on this grain finest number, we will decide the grain size of that molding. So generally, when grain size, grain fineness number is less than this 30, then we will say that this sand is coarse sand. We say that this sand is coarse sand. Coarse sand means what? The grain size is large of that particular sand. When this number increases after 50, means it is, suppose it is more than 50, then we say that this sand is fine sand. Fine sand means what? The grain size is small. Grain size. When it is 30 to 50, then we say that it is a moderate or good molding sand. So any doubt in this, if you have a doubt in this, you can ask in grain finest number. See here, multiplier, they give, generally this is the standard multiplier for every sieve. Suppose there is a topmost sieve, the multiplier is 10. Bottommost multiplier is 200. So these are the multiplier. And sand return is what? We have used 50 gram of sand. There will be some amount of sand in every sieve. We need to find the percentage of sand in that particular sieve. That is the sand rating, right? So suppose, let's suppose out of 50 gram, okay, 20 gram of sand is there in third sieve. So how much amount of sand is there? 40% of sand is there in that particular sieve. So sand rating will be 40% sand in that. So we need to multiply this multiplier and sand return, you will get the product. Add all this product, divide it by 100, you will get the grain finest number. Here we got the grain finest number as 32. Here this sand is good because it is in between 30 to 50%. If it is less than 30, your sand is coarse. Coarse means what? Sand particles are large, and it is supposed to be greater than 50, we call it as a fine, means this sand particles are small. Okay. Any doubt? So this we have finished the testing method, testing of sands. Any doubt? I will take the attendance. In next class, we are going to study detail about core prints, core sand. That part we will see in the next class. So we'll get the detail notes of this particular lecture today. Plus, I will send a quiz also on molding sand. It's a properties, it's a testing, it's a type. Right. Any doubt? Or else we will stop here.
Sir, will you open the slide of grain finest number?
Yes.
Sir, in
yes.
That formula wala slide. Sir, if you got grain finest number greater than 50 and we got some like sand retained is greater than club sum of weights is more than sum of product, then it will be good for casting or not?
Which one we are talking?
This sand retained is greater than like some
50%.
of weights is greater than sum of product, then it is it used for casting process?
No, actually, I am not getting your question. Means what? See here, whatever the sand retain percentage is there, we will not see any about any particular sieve. What we are going to do? We are going to take the summation. What are the product we will get for particular sieve? What we are going to take? We are going to the summation of all this. We will get the total and we will divide it by 100. Right? And depending on this grain fineness number, depending on this grain fineness number, we will decide whether to use that sand or not. Means when it will be between 30 to 50, then we will use that sand. So depending on this multiplier or product, we are not going to decide any particular sieve. The product of any here is 1858. So depending on this, we are not going to decide whether to use or not. Depending on all these factors, product of all this, summation of product of all this, we will get the total. Once you get the total, we will divide by 100 and then we will decide whether to use or not. Depending on total, remember that.
Okay, sir, got it.
Yes. So we'll stop here.